There is one place in all of Lee County that serves as a home for a lot of miscellaneous items. Cars, tools, slot machines, shoes, even paperwork dating back to the 1960s.
All of this stuff is not for sale. It's for safekeeping. NBC2's Sarah Metz walks us through the warehouse full of secrets and stories.
If you didn't know any better, you might think we're inside a mailroom.
We see everything and anything that we can imagine.
With plenty of packages pending delivery. Half of that is true. Things inside this warehouse will be delivered to one address.
We keep things until it's needed in court.
Because you're looking at the power to accuse, convict, or prove innocence.
Our evidence center is one of 11 receiving facilities around the county. This is our main center.
From petty theft to a gruesome murder, the answers are housed here.
Our oldest piece of evidence dates back to 1961.
The crime collection compiled of 177,000 things. Things that might mean nothing to you, yet could mean everything to someone else.
Every single piece of evidence that has a case number attached has a story. It affects someone's life.
The evidence journey to a courtroom starts in a locker.
When the evidence custodians come in the morning, they empty out the lockers from the backside. They'll pull all the evidence out, and now they'll log it into the computer and assign it a barcode.
Each barcode gets branded on a bin, stacked from bottom to top. At first glance, you'd think finding a piece to the pending litigation puzzle would be like finding a needle in a haystack, because one bin holds hundreds.
Some of these things, we have no idea why we have them, but we do.
For high liability evidence, sometimes even a lock and key isn't enough.
This room, as you could see, it had extra locks on the doors. There's extra cameras in this room, and there's extra alarms on this room just to protect the evidence that's inside. Anything from marijuana to fentanyl, cocaine, everything in between, this is where we store it.
A secure space with a smell almost as overwhelming as the evidence inside.
This could have killed a number of people, and because it's here, that's never going to happen. This is our walk-in refrigerator where we store all of our DNA.
Cold yet critical.
Anytime we collect DNA from a scene, we store those extracts after they come back from a lab here in the refrigerator.
According to the National Institute of Justice, DNA evidence is expected by jurors in 22% of cases, 46% in murder cases.
The entire building is important, but DNA can be pivotal in a case. This is our impound where we keep all of the larger evidence.
Like hundreds of seized slot machines.
This is where all of them are stored.
Yes. So we're legally mandated to hold this evidence and to keep it in a working order.
And untouched from the day it was brought in.
We have to preserve it in the way that we found it.
Like this car marked with multiple bullet holes.
So when you have evidence like cars with bullet holes, you can't physically bring that into court. But you have to keep it here on hand.
Yes. Yes, we have to keep it and have it available for the judge and the jury to see.
It will likely never physically see its day in court.
A vehicle that has all these bullet holes, sometimes the judge will order that the judge and the jury and the prosecutor and the defense will come to our building to view this.
To have and to hold until...
Florida state statute tells us what we could do with our evidence and when we can do it.
A lot of it destroyed. Some of it donated. A few items returned.
So it just depends, very case specific.
But the warehouse, much like a mailroom, is never emptied.
It's continuously changing. A lot comes in and out.
We're local today from Lee County, Sarah Metz, NBC2.